How did I meet Hamilton Park? Wow. I actually met Hamilton Park through a former associate of mine. We worked for a promo company together that she owned, and she actually introduced me to Hamilton Park. I ended up branching off and doing my own thing, but I kept in touch with the guys because they were really cool, you know. So it started out as talking on Twitter, and then I started promoting for them, and then eventually another relationship was built. The Hamilton Park Sweethearts started out as a group of four girls who just went insanely hard for Hamilton Park. We supported Hamilton Park, you know, we went hard in the paint. And eventually, the name started to catch on because we did get a lot of accolades and we got so much love from Hamilton Park for showing that love that the name started to catch on, and it ended up becoming a brand, which is now basically any female who supports Hamilton Park is a Hamilton Park sweetheart at the end of the day. So it just grew into something bigger and better, which I think is really cool. And you know, I do my best to try to uphold the name and uphold the title because it was given to me by Hamilton Park as well as the other girls. Things have changed, people change, people go different routes, so some of the originals are not here anymore, but you know, it's grown into such a big, huge thing, such a wonderful brand, and you know, they love their sweethearts to death. Hamilton Park is definitely a fan of a fan, which is something else that you can really appreciate about those guys. At the end of the day, we're still as strong as we always ever were, and the guys are gaining fans more and more as they go out and tour. I mean, you see, even on my timeline, while I'm sitting here promoting, you know, that we're known to flood timelines. We're a force to be reckoned with. And I really think, you know, Hamilton Park needs that support at the end of the day, because when you look at it, they just need to be able to be artists and know that they have that foundation and that backbone to support them no matter what. What made me fall in love with Hamilton Park? What made me fall in love with Hamilton Park was basically their sound. Their sound, their blend, it's amazing. I mean, beyond anything else you've ever heard or seen. You know, these guys, they have an amazing on-stage and off-stage chemistry, which is beneficial to them because that's something that a lot of groups today lack, which is why they don't stay together. Their music, their sound is just so soulful, so passionate. Just, it's, as Andre Herrera likes to say, they're putting love back into the universe. You know, R&B isn't really about love. You know, we have very few real love songs these days, and Hamilton Park is going to be the group that brings that back, that brings that real R&B back into the industry. The one thing that really grabs me about Hamilton Park and has really grabbed me from the beginning is that they're people, you know, they're people. They interact with their fans. They love to be out there and to talk to people. People can really get a feel for who they are. You know what I'm saying? Mr. Marcus, Lee, Anthony, Chris, Royce. It's like you can kind of get an idea who they are individually and as a group. And you know, they have that up close and personal relationship with their fans, which I think is really, really, really awesome. From the moment I first heard Special Delivery, which was a single they were pushing at the time that I met them, I was in love with their music because it was just real soulful, real R&B. Like, you don't get that nowadays from a lot of these groups, even, you know, solo artists. You don't really get that And these guys just have such a passion, such a drive, and such a motivation. I knew then that I needed to be a part of this movement. I needed to be a part of this family. You know what I'm saying? And over time, that's what I became. One of the biggest things that I really respect about Hamilton Park is they're not afraid to go out there and grind and do their own work. They have a music for whether you're young, old, male, female, black, white, whatever. You can appreciate everything that they do, and nobody puts on a live show like Hamilton Park. Hamilton Park memories, like good memories, embarrassing moments. There's so many candid things that happen around Hamilton Park because those guys are hilarious. They, you know, when you get the four of them in a room, they're just so charismatic. They're comedians. They're just amazing. So there's actually so many memories for me to really, you know, recall about Hamilton Park just from everything. And, you know, I can't really take a specific, you know, good memory from that, but there's just everything. Just I love being around them. Their aura is amazing. Their energy is amazing. Just being around them just makes you have this instantaneous joy that's just like, oh my god, like, you know, it's something you've never really experienced before. So definitely hanging out with them is an experience, and we have so many memories, you know, that I've gained that will last my lifetime. It's been a very rewarding experience to work with them.
What about the rain?
Wow, my god. Every time I hear them on the radio or see them on television or just watching them perform, even, you know, it honestly brings tears to my eyes because they're like my family. I love Hamilton Park so much. L7, everybody. Shout out to Frame, Yancey, everybody, you know, in Atlantic, Andre Harrell, Harrell Records, L7 Management, Square Biz. Just shout out to everybody. You know, we're like one big family. And, you know, having this connection, you know, relationship with Hamilton Park, those are my brothers and I love them to death, you know what I'm saying? Having this relationship with them, when they win, when they make it, when they succeed, it feels like I succeed. You know, it feels like everybody who's worked with them has succeeded when they succeed. And, you know, it's a really, really rewarding experience and a really amazing feeling that it brings tears to my eyes, literally, you know. Anthony likes to make fun of me and call me a water bag. He says I cry too much. But I cry, you know, when I first saw Computer Love on MTV Jams, I was screaming and crying. My grandmother busted my room, like, what's wrong, what's wrong? And then she looks at the TV and saw the Computer Love video and goes, oh. You know, she knows about Hamilton Park. My family is actually really supportive of Hamilton Park. My mom supports Hamilton Park, and I think that that's, you know, really cool. It's really big for me. every time I see them perform live or see the video on TV or hear their song on the radio, it's like a proud parent moment. Every time it's like the first time, and immediately I'm overcome with these tears of joy. You know, they're a very special group of guys, and I'm very glad to have been a part of the legacy and a part of making them where they are and a part of their heart.
This is a very historical moment. We right here. We about to go take a shot in front of Motown, Hitsville, USA, baby. We in Detroit. Hamilton Park is taking over Detroit right now.
Yes.
I mean, waiting on my other brothers to get out the van right now.
Come on,
it's
y'all.
It's gonna go digital real quick.
You know what I'm saying? They can't keep us down. This rain can't keep us down.
The best thing to me about working with Hamilton Park is the family bond that everybody has. You know, everybody on the team, we're not just a team, we're a family. You know what I'm saying? I think that that's the most rewarding thing to me about working with Hamilton Park, is that I feel like I have a new family here. You know, we all stick together, we go hard, everybody believes in this, and at the end of the day, everybody wants this. Like I said earlier, you feel like you're winning because they're winning. And I think that that bond, and you know what I'm saying, just the places that the potential they have, the places they could go, and the places that they've been, the places that they're going, you know, it's very rewarding and it's very amazing seeing somebody else's dream come to life and you being just as passionate about that dream and being a part of making it happen. For the future of Hamilton Park, I see them blowing up and being really big. You know, Boyz II Men, Jodeci, Jagged Edge, 112, they were really, really big artists. And I feel like, you know, this bond and the chemistry that they have is going to really benefit them in the long run. I feel like because of that, you know, big things are going to happen. I pray for them constantly, all the time, and I do my best, you know, and do my part to make sure that happens. As a matter of fact, to show, you know, how much I pray for them, this is my Bible. I actually, funny thing, yesterday I'm going through my Bible and I find my Hamilton Park bookmark in the Bible. And, you know, I actually twit-picked and tweeted them about it, and I told them, you know, it's funny, I found my bookmark in the Bible. And so they tweeted me back and they go, keep us in your word. So honestly, my Hamilton Park bookmark is gonna stay in my Bible. I'm gonna keep them in the word. I'm gonna shift it around daily to different Bible verses that I feel like they need to be empowered with. You know, I might actually tweet them to them, but you know what I'm saying? In the future, I see star. All I see is the stars. The sky is the limit. And that's not even really a limit, because Hamilton Park, L7, all that, they know no limits. You know what I'm saying? There's nothing anybody in this team can and won't do to get to the top. And I really feel like, you know what I'm saying, this family bond and everything, as long as we stay together to really, really help push this dream, then who knows what we can accomplish. At the end of the day, Hamilton Park is more than just a band. They are a legacy. They are a brotherhood filled with love and spirituality. This isn't about us. This is God's work. And you know, I just really thank Atlantic for embracing the vision and the dream of Frank, Yancey, and the Boyz, because I feel like with everybody's love, help, and support, this can be turned into a legacy that will last a lifetime.
Don't even act like you ain't never built up.